आई विल हैव टू रिकॉर्ड अगेन ऑल दिस थिंग. ओके राइट, आई विल स्टार्ट अगेन. सो दिस इज अवर टॉपिक, इवोल्यूशनरी ट्रेंड एंड इकोडाई, राइट. सो इकोडाई इज हॉर्स ओनली ना, इवोल्यूशन ऑफ हॉर्स एंड द नेम ऑफ हॉर्स, मॉडर्न हॉर्स इज इक्वस, राइट. द वन ऑफ द अर्लिएस्ट हॉर्स हिज नेम इज यूहिप्पस, राइट. लाइक इफ यू, इवन इफ यू आर नॉट फ्रॉम जियोलॉजी बैकग्राउंड, यू मस्ट हैव सम टाइम हर्ड अबाउट दिस नेम यूहिप्पस, राइट. सो जर्नी ऑफ हॉर्स फ्रॉम यूहिप्पस टू इक्वस, दिस इज वॉट द इवोल्यूशन ऑफ हॉर्स इज ऑल अबाउट. ऑलराइट, देयर माइट बी अदर स्पीशीज लाइक इन 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 ह्यूमंस वी स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम आर्बोरियल इंसेक्टिवोरस, ऑलराइट, और प्रोपेलोपिथेकस. सो जर्नी ऑफ लाइक द स्पीशीज फ्रॉम प्रोपेलोपिथेकस टू होमोसेपियंस सेपियंस, एंड देन केम अ लॉट ऑफ ना, देर वॉज अ लॉट ऑफ कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी, बट देन देयर केम ड्रायोपिथेकस, ऑस्ट्रेलोपिथेकस, होमो हैबिलिस, होमो इरेक्टस एंड ना अ लॉट अदर थिंग्स. सिमिलर सिमिलर अप्रोच इज दिस ना, वी विल हैव द सेम अप्रोच. वी विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम यूहिप्पस, आई विल टेल यू वॉट इज यूहिप्पस, ऑल दिस थिंग, एंड देन वी विल रीड फ्यू अदर्स, ऑल राइट. वी विल रिमेंबर फ्यू 10-15 नेम्स एंड वी आर गुड टू गो टू स्कोर एटलीस्ट 90% मार्क्स इन दिस क्वेश्चन. एंड वी ऑल्सो डिस्कस दैट द यूपीएससी आस्क वेरी डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन ऑन दिस ऑल्सो, राइट. सो लाइक जस्ट टू स्टार्ट विथ, वी विल फर्स्ट डिस्कस वॉट चेंजेस हैव हैपेंड, राइट. वी आर नॉट गोइंग इन टू डिटेल ऑफ दी स्पीशीज कि फ्रॉम यूहिप्पस देयर वॉज ओरोहिप्पस, देन देयर वॉज मायोहिप्पस, और प्लायोहिप्पस, अ लॉट ऑफ स्पीशीज केम अप. बट जनरल वॉट हैपेंड वॉज लाइक, फर्स्ट आई वॉज सेइंग यू दिस इवोल्यूशन ऑफ हॉर्स, मॉडर्न हॉर्स, इट हैपेंड इन नॉर्थ अमेरिका, ऑल राइट. एंड ड्यू टू सम रीजन वी हैव अ वेरी गुड फॉसिल रिकॉर्ड ऑफ हॉर्स, राइट. वन ऑफ द रीजन इज दैट दीज हॉर्सेस और प्रिमिटिव हॉर्सेस, नॉट द मॉडर्न हॉर्सेस, दे लिव्ड इन हर्ड्स, भीड़ में रहते थे, एंड मे बी नेचुरल डिजास्टर स्ट्रक, मे बी डिसीज केम, सो दे ऑल्सो डाइड टूगेदर, एंड ड्यू टू दी फेवरेबल कंडीशन देयर फॉसिल वॉज रिमेन इंटैक्ट. सो वी हैव अ लॉट ऑफ फॉसिल ऑफ दीज एनिमल, ऑल राइट, स्पेशली इन दी नॉर्थ अमेरिका. सो दे इवॉल्व, सो नॉर्थ अमेरिका इज नोन एज क्रेडल ऑफ इक्वाइन इवोल्यूशन, राइट. दिस इफ समबडी इज गिविंग एन ऑब्जेक्टिव जियोलॉजी एग्जाम, सो दिस दिस दे मे आस्क यू नॉर्थ अमेरिका ना, इट इज अ कॉन्टिनेंट. सो सी, सो ना वॉट चेंजेस हैपन वॉज, फर्स्ट चेंज वॉज देर वॉज चेंज इन एनवायरमेंट, राइट. सो ड्यूरिंग द टाइम ऑफ दिस यूहिप्पस, इट इज द अर्लिएस्ट हॉर्स, राइट. सो ड्यूरिंग द टाइम ऑफ यूहिप्पस, मोस्टली इन द पेलियोसीन यूसीन टाइम, नॉर्थ अमेरिका वॉज अ मोस्टली अ फॉरेस्टेड एरिया, और नॉट इवन अ फॉरेस्टेड एरिया, बट इट इज इट वॉज अ डेंस स्वैम्पी फॉरेस्ट, राइट. यू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट इज स्वैम्प, दलदल काइंड ऑफ ना, देर वॉज वॉटर ऑल्सो देयर. सो इट वॉज अ स्वैम्प डेंस स्वैम्पी फॉरेस्ट, एंड देर वॉज सम क्लाइमेट चेंज इन दैट टाइम ना, इन इन सीनोजोइक एरा ग्लोबली क्लाइमेट चेंज्ड, ऑल राइट. लाइक वी टॉक्ड अबाउट द केटी एक्सटिंक्शन, ऑल राइट. सो वॉट वॉज हैपनिंग इन केटी एक्सटिंक्शन, केटी मतलब क्रिटेशियस, एंड दिस इज सीनोजोइक टर्शियरी, दिस इज टर्शियरी टाइम, ऑल राइट. सो वॉट वॉज हैपनिंग, डायनासोर वॉज गेटिंग एक्सटिंक्ट. सो वॉट वॉज द रीजन ऑफ एक्सटिंक्शन ऑफ डायनासोर, लाइक देवर अ लॉट ऑफ रीजन. वन ऑफ द रीजन वी स्पेकुलेट इज दी इम्पैक्ट ऑफ मीटियोराइट, ऑल राइट. ऑल्सो देर वॉज अ लॉट ऑफ वॉल्केनिक इरोजन. इफ एनी वन ऑफ यू हैव सीन दी मूवी जुरासिक पार्क, यू कुड रिलेट, ऑल राइट. सो देर वॉज ऑल्सो सम वॉल्केनिक इरोजन. सो वॉट वॉल्केनिक, सॉरी, एक्सप्लोजन, वॉल्केनिक एक्सप्लोजन, ऑल राइट. सो वॉट हैपन्स दैट अ लॉट ऑफ ऐश एंड अदर वॉल्केनिक मटेरियल वॉज एमिटेड, एंड दे प्रिवेंटेड सनलाइट फ्रॉम कमिंग टू द अर्थ, ऑल राइट. सो देर वॉज इन जनरल डिक्लाइन इन द टेम्परेचर इन दिस यूनोजोइक एरा, ऑल राइट. एंड दिस डिक्लाइन इन द टेम्परेचर कल्मिनेटेड इन प्लीस्टोसिन टाइम. एंड वॉट इज लाइक फॉर वॉट प्लीस्टोसिन इज फेमस फॉर,
आइस एज
यस, आइस एजेस, ऑल राइट. So there was a general decline in the temperature. There was, some deflections also in between, but no, just for simplification, there was a general decline in the temperature. So these forests, they become, grassland, firm grassland. So this was one environmental change happening in the North America. All right. So this was an environmental change. What other things happened? All right. Let's discuss in the another train. So like these are also my notes. These are also the final product. This I will share with you. So see there, here the lineage is pretty, linear. The evolution tree is pretty simple. It is not as complex as humans. So these are some names. Euhippus. Like don't get bogged down by these names. I will tell you a way to remember them. But just for your, sense of comfort, I am just taking these name here. So one is this is Euhippus. Now, then we have Orohippus, then we have Epihippus, all right, Mesohippus, Mayo, Para, Marich, Proto, something like this. Then Pliocene time mein, what horse was there? It was known as Pliocene, right? In Miocene, the horse name was Myohippus, all right. In Oligocene, it was what? Orohippus, something like that. In Eocene time, it was Eohippus. So a lot of names are derived from the time period in which they first appeared. All right, and then we have Equus, and then the modern Equus. All right, there were some division in Hipparion, all these things. So don't worry, you need to make your own mnemonic for it. So I made a very simple mnemonic: E O E M. I am from MP, so there were two MPs here, and then I know Pliocene and Equus, something like this. All right, I searched this on YouTube. So this is not my creation. I saw a video. It was from some biology teacher, and she made this trick, right? So if you are from Hindi background, you can use this trick, right? Ek aur mere liye mayonnaise packet mat purchase karna. So E for na ek for this is E. This is for Orohippus. It is for Mesohippus, Myohippus, like Parahippus. This M is for Marichhippus, Pliohippus, and last we have Equus, right? So like this, like I was told by a lot of friends that I should not do all these things in the class. It gives an unprofessional look, but I don't care. I just want you all to remember these names in whatever way you can. So I'm just giving you some way to remember it. All right. So like you make your own if you can. If you are from southern India or from northeastern India, you are not very comfortable with Hindi, you make your own one. All right, I just remember this something like this EOEM MPMP, and I could able to recall it in the exam. So my notes of my final short note for evolutionary trend in Equus was nothing is what it was, just one liner note and this one. All right, and I just using this line, I got this question right in both IFS as well as CSE. All right, and not once but thrice. So I am pretty sure, I go got this just using this one line. So make your own mnemonic, all right, and you will get comfortable in after some minutes about this. So this we will study in the end. I think we started 15 minutes late, so we will extend the class by 15 minutes. All right, this we will discuss. So just for your basic understanding, we are starting this Equus. Right. Just let me check whether the recording is on or not again. All right. So see, I discussed that this is one of the most better documented fossil in paleontology, and fossil records are found extensively in North America. Right. So this is some Myohippus. Right. This is just an introductory slide. Like you can see ki, and one more thing about horse is that apart from general trend, UPSC, like they haven't asked yet a lot of time, but I think UPSC could be like focusing next on the evolutionary trends in the foot of horse, in the foot of horse, right? Foot or maybe toe. So this is a very very interesting and prominent feature in equine evolution. So this is just an introductory see. So again, if you can remember this could be asked in interview. and you can write it in exam also. So this Equidae, they belong to animal kingdom just like human, Chordata phylum, and they are also mammal. So this is common with human. Then this is not other, it is order. Order is Perissodactyla. All right. If possible, remember it. You can even ignore it if you are not very comfortable. But remember this, na? These are very easy. So they are from Equidae family. UPS has mentioned us the family itself. Equidae family, Equus genus and Equus species. Right? They are Equus species only. So this is a general trend. Right? Now you people, like you did with humans, you tell me what general thing could you observe in this trend. Right? This is the earliest horse, quote unquote horse, the most ancient ancestor of horse, which we call as Eohippus. Then there are some other names, ignore it, Meso, Marsupial, whatever, but you can at least see the diagram. Tell me what are the things you could observe in this diagram. Anyone awake?
So
Height
height
increased.
is
Height is increasing. Very good. What else?
getting hairy.
Achha. Okay. I don't know, but okay. You are like something related to hairs. All right. And you can see the size. Sorry.
Foot of the horse leg.
Something like I cannot, it is not audible, but I think something related to foot. So I think yes, the length of the
Single hoof.
legs are increasing. All right, you can also see there is also an increase in this size. All right, this size. All right, what else you can see?
So muscular.
It is becoming more muscular. Obviously, its brain size would also be increasing, which like. This is a normal evolution. All right. Brain capacity must be increasing. And also you cannot see the foot, but like I have used this small image here. There is a change in the foot also. All right. Earlier they had five toe. All right. Some species have 4 to 5 toes. You can see here. All right. Then they become three toed. Then what happens is that the digits of the toe, you can see ye chote hote ja rahe hai na, they are becoming smaller. And this is the bigger one. So this might not even be touching the ground. All right. And then all these fingers got disappeared. We get only a single toed horse. And the modern horse is also a single toed. So you can see it is the most important feature. It was a five toed animal. It has become one toed. One thing is also there is a development of hoof. All right, like when I was reading this like I didn't have much interest in wildlife. It was like years ago, right? So I didn't even know what is hoof, and I was very very shy to ask me what is the meaning of hoof, because everybody sitting around me in the college, they know what is hoof. I was even confused ki what is the difference between toe and fingers, all right, and why you are taking the names like digit. So like if you have such doubts, like feel free. You are learning from a guy who also learn all these things on his own, right? So don't worry, I have included all these things in the slide itself, like for your understanding. So like this is, don't worry, we'll come to that thing in few minutes, right? So this is a general evolution. So like I said, this Orohippus, Epihippus, Mesohippus, Myohippus is all right. Then there's Pera, Messi, all these things. So this is a general evolution. One change is, one trend is. See this. This is nothing but the lag, right? So it was from four toe or maybe five toed to they become three, they become then two, one and four, they become extinct, three become more prominent, and then presently in Equus we have a single toe one. So if anyone of you like today we live in a modern society, we are not much, we don't have much interface with the horse, but maybe if you are from a school which has horse riding or you are lucky enough not to see the hoof. Leg of the horse, you can understand this pretty easily. So don't worry, I have included few slides, all right, about the horse. You will see there. Presently, the only interface with horse is during marriages, right? The groom sits on it. That's it. And we don't have much interface with this beautiful animal, right? So like this is a very common line written in the books. This is not very important from geology point of view, but still I've used it that Wikipedia says that horses are odd-toed ungulates. All right. So I hope you know what is the meaning of odd. No, this is even and odd. So 1, 3, 5, something like this. Even is 2, 4, 6, something like this. So they have odd number of toes. So horses must be having 1, 3, 5 kind of so presently the modern horse have one toe only. So they are odd toed. And ungulate is some animal which have hoof. All right, or hoof. So what is hoof? Hoof is this. You must have seen even cattle. If you have seen cow, even it has such hooves. All right. So this is basically nail kind of a thing. All right. This is just a single toe, and this you can see. You can like have learn it like this is nothing but a nail kind of a thing. Right. So I hope now you understand what is hoof.
It's like tip of the toe.
Yes, perfect, perfect. It is actually tip of the toe. Sorry, tip of the toe. Right, just like we have this nail, na, the surface of the nail, that is something like this. This is hoof. So this developed in them. All right. So like there are animals can be classified on the basis of number of toes. All right. So ungulate refers to an animal which have hoof. So it could be, you know, rhinoceros have hoof, horse have hoofs, even cattle, pig, hippos, camel, all these have hoofs. So these are ungulates, a different kind of ungulates. So you don't have to go in detail. Right, you can see this is bovine, the cow and all, they have two toes. This is horse, it has a single toe. Now rhinos have generally three toes. Horse has one. So this is just for your understanding, not important for exam point of view. But like if you are smart enough, if you understand all this, you can chepo this line, na, in exam. Horses are odd-toed ungulates. Without getting bothered about the terminology, right? So this is it. Now, just somebody like I took this class in one of the crash course, and a guy was like very shy to ask me the difference between toe and finger and all these things. So he was getting confused on this terminology itself. So just if maybe someone might be here also who is confusing, like these are more or less the same thing. Finger, we talk about finger in terms of our hands, right? All these digits of our hands, apart from the thumb, we call them finger, right? Similarly, the digits of our legs, we call them toes. So horse don't have hands, na? In a sense, all its limbs could be classified as legs. So we talk about toe there. All right. So like based on this toes are the digits of the foot of a tetrapod. All right. So something like this. You don't have to go in detail of this. Right. I just use it for doubt purpose, right? So I've also written here the difference between toe and finger if you want to read, but I hope like it is finger related to hand, toe is related to the foot, right? So we talk about toe in all this. So like equus is a genus, all right? This include horse, zebras, donkeys, all these things, right? So see, and the best part is the history of horse, it originated, like it began around 50 million year ago. Just remember this fact. Right? You don't have to go on all this. This equus, the history of equus evolution, it started about 50 million year ago. So 50 million year ago is somewhere around Oligocene, I think. All right, Paleocene, Oligocene boundary. Right. So what changes happened? What are the evolutionary? This is the last slide, and specifically we will study tomorrow. So what are the changes happened in the horses, right? So I want to show you a picture. This is what this is Eohippus. Now up teen char var I have taken this name. I have taken this name 4 or 5 times. Eohippus. So at least you should be comfortable with this name. And this is modern horse. So if you put both of them in a picture, this is what they will look like. Right, so the history of evolution of horses, इस हिस्ट्री और इस जर्नी फ्रॉम हिप्पस यू हिप्पस टू मॉडर्न हॉर्स. ऑल राइट, सो लाइक व्हाट चेंजेस आर हैपेंड, यू ऑलरेडी हैव टॉकन, सी इट्स साइज हैज इंक्रीज, राइट, वेट हैज इंक्रीज, ऑब्वियसली साइज विल इंक्रीज, वेट विल इंक्रीज. ऑल राइट, देन यू कैन सी दैट हियर द बैक इज विट कर्वी लीनियर, राइट, एंड हियर द बैक इज मोर लीनियर. ऑल राइट, एंड इट द बैक हैज ऑल्सो स्टिफंड. वाई इट इज स्टिफंड, बिकॉज ह्यूमन स्टार्टेड सिटिंग ऑन दैम. ऑल राइट, ह्यूमन स्टार्टेड सिटिंग ऑन दैम, सो लाइक एंड इट इज ऑल्सो यूज फॉर दिस पर्पज ऑल्सो. सो इवोल्यूशनरी ऑल्सो इट बैक स्टिफंड ना, दे वर नॉट कैपेबल ऑफ दिस. सो एक्चुअली यू कैन सी इट इज जस्ट अ पिग लाइक क्रिएचर. और यू कैन से इट इज इट फॉक्स लाइक क्रिएचर. ऑल राइट, सो साइज वाइज इट वॉज प्रिटी मच लाइक ए फॉक्स. एंड विथ टाइम वॉट हैपन्स इज हिज इट्स साइज ऑफ द लिम्स इंक्रीजेस. ना यू कैन ऑल्सो सी दीज लेग्स आर बिकमिंग वेरी वेरी पावरफुल. दैट इज वाई इट कुड यू नो इट कुड गैलप कैंटर ऑल दिस थिंग. लाइक हॉर्स के चार तरह के वॉक होते हैं ना. वन हॉर्स कैन वॉक हॉर्स, देन इफ इट इज जॉगिंग वी कॉल इट ट्रॉट. वेन हॉर्स इज यू नो रनिंग फास्ट वी कॉल इट कैंटर. एंड देन वेन इट इज रनिंग फास्टेस्ट वी कॉल इट गैलपिंग. यू मस्ट हैव रेड ऑल दिस इन एज एन इंग्लिश वर्ड्स, राइट. इट हैज नथिंग टू डू विद जियोलॉजी, बट इट इज जस्ट फॉर योर जनरल फैक्टॉइड थिंग. सो लाइक इफ यू आर इन टू हॉर्स राइडिंग, दे विल स्टार्ट विद वॉक, देन दे विल आस्क यू टू ट्रॉट द हॉर्स, देन कैंटर, एंड इफ यू बिकम अ प्रो दे यू विल समडे गैलप द हॉर्स, राइट. दिस इज इट. सो दिस इज वॉट आई वॉन्ट टू डिस्कस हियर, राइट. वॉट आर द इवोल्यूशनरी चेंजेस टेकिंग प्लेस? वन इज इन द रिडक्शन ऑफ टोज. ऑल राइट, फ्रॉम 5 टो टू 1 टो. कैन एनीबडी टेल मी, इफ समबडी टेल मी दिस आंसर, आई विल गिव हिम अ चॉकलेट और गिव हर अ चॉकलेट. ऑल राइट, अ बिग डेरी मिल्क. कि वाई दिस नंबर ऑफ टो माइट बी डिक्रीजिंग? आई होप यू आर स्टिल देयर अवे अवे.
यस सर,
ओके, सो टेल मी, दिस इज अ चॉकलेट क्वेश्चन, व्हाई देयर कुड बी अ डिक्लाइन इन द टो?
सर बिकॉज़ हॉर्स रन फास्ट, जस्ट बिकॉज़ ऑफ दैट रीजन.
या प्रिटी प्रिटी क्लोज. सो एक्चुअली दिस इज द रीजन. विथ वन टो लाइक अर्लियर
And so because planes were getting developed in North America.
yes, very good. So it is related to both the things, like both of you, one told that about the running, it could run fast, and one told about the environment. So actually what was happening was when Eohippus originated, it came into existence, the climate in North America was forested, right? It was dense forest. So इट इज वेरी इजी टू हाइड इन द फॉरेस्ट. ना पेड़ के पीछे छुप सकते हो, यू कैन ना हाइड बिहाइंड अ बुश. ऑल राइट, ऑल्सो इन फॉरेस्ट एक्चुअली वी कॉल लायन एज द किंग ऑफ जंगल. ऑल राइट, द किंग ऑफ द फॉरेस्ट. बट एक्चुअली टाइगर एंड लायन, एक्चुअली लायन इट डज नॉट लिव इन फॉरेस्ट. ऑल राइट, इट डज नॉट लिव इन फॉरेस्ट, दे मोस्टली लिव इन ग्रासलैंड. दिस इज अ वेरी बेसिक अंडरस्टैंडिंग. अगर आपने डीपली सोचा हो कभी इस बारे में, तो वो एक्चुअली दे लिव इन ग्रासलैंड, बिकॉज इन फॉरेस्ट एक्चुअली इन डेंस फॉरेस्ट टाइगर कैन लिव इन ऑल डिफिकल्ट टेरेन, बट लायन डोंट लाइक फॉरेस्टेड एरिया. दे लिव देर माइट बी सम ट्रीज, बट इट इज एसेंशियली अ ग्रासलैंड. ऑल राइट, अ डेसिडियस फॉरेस्ट काइंड ऑफ अ थिंग. सो व्हाट हैपेंस इज इन फॉरेस्ट देर इज लेस रूम टू यू नो रन फास्ट. ऑल राइट, so lion will die of hunger if it lives in a dense forest, because it cannot hunt. In grassland it is all open. So but think from a point of view of horse or horse like creature. When there was forest it could hide, but when it become grassland, it has nowhere to go. When if a carnivore is trying to hunt it down, it has to run for its life. All right, so this was related to that only, and it was environmental induced, but it was also for its running. All right, so when there are four, five all right, like there is a picture I shared. See this picture, all right? I don't know, somebody is asking for an entry when we are about to end the class. All right. So, see this. Evolutionary trends in horse. So, if you'll see, these are five fingers. So, it like if suppose this is your foot, it is difficult to run faster, all right? Similarly, see, what now it is slowly, just standing on its tip of its toe. All right, on the tip of its toe instead of standing on its sole, like we humans do. It is always on its toe. So it is pretty easy to run. All right, it is easy to run faster with this something. So this is a very, very, you know, primitive explanation of it, but this is the feel of it, right? It could run faster with one single toe. So present horse has a single toe because of this thing only. So you can see what are the changes, evolutionary changes happening in its leg from 3 or 5 toed. These fingers are getting lost. They got extinct here and it is single toed so that it can run fast. Another thing in terms of skeletal. And this is a smaller bone. The bone is getting bigger and more importantly, stronger. You know, there are some couple of bones. A famous bone is fibula. All right, and some other. So these are fusing. Now here they were different. Here they are fusing. So the leg is becoming more muscular. Like if you ever heard about a horse hitting a kick to any person, now he might even die because these are very, very powerful legs, right? They could generate a lot of pace while running, and they can even fracture your multiple bones with just a single kick. So they are very, very muscular and powerful legs, right? So what else is changing? One is reduction in the toes. We dwelled on the reason of it. Second thing is elongation of the legs. All right, just we saw it. Increase in the body size from fox-like to modern horse. All right, elongation of the muzzle. So like, what is muzzle? Muzzle is how to, this is forgive me for like
the mouth part.
Yes, the mouth part. All right. So the area in front of the eyes. All right. I should erase it. Area in front of eyes. Right. So this is elongation of muzzle happen. So this happens because it gives it could eat grass from a distance. All right. And it could see if the mouth is very close to eyes. Now, while eating, it becomes more prone to predation, right? Then there was changes in the teeth, right? The teeth become highly crowned. Like this, you need to rectify, but just ki aapko yaad ho jaye this technical terms. Like when I use bhi kiya, I use these. So like, what is a crown? This is a teeth. This is a human or any teeth of any animal. This is anatomy of a tooth. So ye jo hard part hota hai na, we call it crown. Right, this is the inner part, this is the outer part, right? Crown. So this hard part is crown. So with time, as it started eating more and more grasses, and grass is like pretty hard because it has high amount of silica, right? So when it, so just for protection purpose, its teeth started crowning. So even if you are able to write this 5 and some general point on evolution of trend, you have scored already 50% marks. All right, just by general understanding. So these are my bad handwritten notes. So like, I think now you can understand. Increase in the size from 30 centimeter to abhi 1.5 to 2 meters tak hota hai na, modern horse. Sorry. Then there is reduction of, I use this technical terms, ulna and fibula. So these are nothing but these are the names of bones of the legs. These are general terms. If you have read science in 8th and 9th standard, you must be knowing. All right. So actually, this ulna and fibula, these are two different bones here. You know, this is nothing but leg. Like yesterday, somebody was asking, can I draw a diagram? Right. So if you want to draw a diagram of leg, you can draw this diagram. It is given in all the books. And, you know, everybody, like I was pretty afraid of drawing this because I thought, kitni kalakari kaun karega? But you can draw it. It will give you additional 2 marks, right? So this is not, you just have to draw simple leg, draw this junction, it is known as carpal. This lower part is metacarpal, So this is what we are talking about, Eohippus. And then it has what? Four toes. Alright, something like this. So these are toes. You can draw this, not bigger deal. There are obviously some ligaments. And then there were some specialized bones here. Alright. One is known as ulna, other one is known as fibula, or sometimes also radia. So what happens is, this was Eohippus. In equus, what happens is, these five toes disappeared and it became a single toe. Alright. And also there was simplification of these. There were like this radia and ulna, these two bones, these are names of the bone. Right? The somebody is Vijay, somebody is Vinny, somebody is like, so these are the name of the bones. Alright. So this is radia and ulna, they fuse together. So just simple diagram you can draw, nothing fancy about it. Right. So apart from this, there is fusion of ulna and radia. Then there is reduction in the toes. We discuss about it. What are the changes in the face? There is lengthening of the muzzle or lengthening of the area in front of the eyes. And there was deepening of the skull. Right? The skull, it started to sit more deep. So it could even avoid injuries and all these things. Apart from that, there is strengthening and stiffening of the back so that it could be sit upon by humans in their marriages. Right? So this is an evolutionary change, strengthening and straightening and stiffening of the back. Then there was changes in some dental structure, molarization of premolars, increase. Obviously, this is a common for all the animals, right? What? Increase in the size and the complexity of the brain, the cranial capacity increased, lengthening of the limbs, all these things. So just by your common sense, you can generate these 10 points. You don't have to mug all these things, right? Even if you sleep today, just when you sleep, just remember, can you produce these 10 points for evolutionary changes in the horse? And like,
sir, what does premolar means?
Like, I'll cover this tomorrow in tomorrow class. Like, we have, I think, four kind of teeth. It is about teeth. Read something about it. One kind of teeth is canine. And jo samne pehne jo daant hote hai na, from the one we cut, we call it canine. Then we have incisor, if I'm right. Anybody can help me here. The third one is premolar. And the fourth one, we call it dar, right? It is molar. So these are four kind of teeth. They have their specific purpose. The canine is used for tearing, right? If you have seen a dog, or maybe if you have seen a tiger, the teeth which are in front, those nukele, the very, what we call it? Very pointed teeth, we call them canine and incisor. The inner teeth, they are known as molar and premolar. So there are some advantages of molar and premolar. If you will see in buffaloes, they have a weaker molar than a premolar. So what they do is, what they just tear the foot and they just gulp it inside, and then later they digest it. So it is these teeth are chewers. Now you chew whatever you eat, you just observe it, how you eat today's dinner. So you will eat and then the food will go a bit deeper and you'll chew from the molars and the premolars. All right. So something like that, molarization of premolar. More I'll take up it in the next class, maybe something about dental. But I think you now know about these terms, right? Premolar and molar. This is a kind of teeth, right? So this is the evolution. So like I said, again, this is the final slide. We'll come back to it. Now, again, I would just want to tell you this slide so that when we come last, it won't be something new to you, right? So first is Eohippus, then Orohippus, then came Mesohippus, Myohippus, E-O-M-P-M-P. And from Protohippus in the Miocene time, now there becomes a lot of branch. One is this Hippidian and Hypohippidian. Both of them are extinct. What Hippidian? This Hippidian. Like I put these my notes additionally just to give an idea ki aapke khud ke notes kaise honge. Right? I could skip this. Ki, like Lawrence sir also uses only this slide. I can also do that, but I just use these slides to give you an idea. But unfortunately, I don't have a very good handwriting. So it hinders a bit of learning. But don't worry, I'll write it here. Like, this is Hippidian, this is Hypohippidian. From Protohippus, there come this Priohippus, and some variety of equus, which got extinct in Pleistocene, right? There was this very famous Hipparion also, right? Hypohippus, it got extinct. And then from this equus, we have this modern horses. These modern horses converted into feral horses and something like this, right? And from here only, these equus only, we have other cousins of the horse. What are the cousins of horse? This zebra. All right, these are the cousins of horse. So these are zebra. Where do you find zebra? Do you find zebra in India?
No, yes. Sir.
They are found in Africa only.
Africa.
Nah, you must have seen in documentaries, in very, very, very favorite prey of a tiger and maybe cheetah. They always hunt these zebras. So these are, so something like this. Similarly, all right. One again thing we should remember is, unfortunately, even though the North America is the cradle of cradle of horse evolution, but presently, like few years ago, horse got completely extinct from North America. Right, even though horse evolved in North America, so like this is the what is this? Can anybody tell me what is this?
Americas.
Thank you, bhai. I thought ki samajh nahi aa raha. Okay, so this is North. This is Europe. This is North America. This is South America. This is Atlantic Ocean. This is Pacific Ocean. Right? Like, see, I draw. I am using it a pen tab, so that is why it is not coming very neat. But I like me, you should also be able to draw the diagram of world map in 20 seconds, right? So practice this. Right? This comes very handy in general studies, paper 1, paper 3, even in 2 international relations. This is very, very handy. Even in geology, it gives you 1 mark extra. All right. So draw it in 20 seconds. In next class, I will draw it in a more neater way. So they, even though they originated here, then with time, they are found here also. And when what happens was that when there was ice age. Now here this is Alaska, and you must have heard about Bering Strait, right? So there is a bridge, Bering Bridge we call it. So when there was ice age, in ice age what happens to sea level? It increase or decrease?
Decreases.
Yes, it decreases. So sea level go much down, and this rocks got exposed. So we call it a Bering Bridge. So what happens is this North America, Alaska got connected to Russia, Siberia through this bridge. So these horse migrated to they migrated to Siberia, Eurasia basically. They migrated to Arab, right? Africa, everywhere. But unfortunately, due to whatever reason, which is yet not certain, they got wiped out from Americas, right? They got wiped out from Americas. So horses are not naturally forming Americas presently. They did got reintroduced there in 16th century by Spanish people, right? So like this is something. So you can see whatever was happening in North America, here is North America, Eurasia, South America. This was a diagram in the book, so I copied it here. So see, all this evolution was happening in North America. This Protohippus, it got migrated to South America and it converted into Hippidian and then Hypohippidian, and it also got extinct. Here, this North American equus also got extinct, right? So here, this equus, it migrated into Eurasia during Pleistocene time. Can you see the diagram here, Vijay and everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay, right. So, see, this same species migrated here in Eurasia during the Ice Ages, during Pleistocene time. And then in Africa, it evolved into zebra and S, right? Mostly in Ethiopia and other regions, Tanzania, right? And when it came to Asia, especially Arab countries, here, it converted into equus. And from equus, this non-domesticated wild we carried it to North America, and similarly we carried it to South America. So it is not naturally found, it is human induced. This chain is human induced. Right. इतना लिखने की जरूरत नहीं है एग्जाम में, बट जस्ट इफ यू लाइक आई शेयर दिस बिकॉज इससे कुछ और डायमेंशन आपकी अंडरस्टैंडिंग के खुल जाएंगे. राइट आपको नहीं पता बट द एग्जामिनर जो कॉपी चेक कर रहा है उसको तो पता है कि नॉर्थ अमेरिका में एक्सटिंक्ट हो चुके हैं. तो इस डायग्राम में जस्ट राइटिंग जस्ट पुटिंग दिस डॉटेड डायग्राम हियर आई हैव यू नो इंक्लूडेड अ लॉट ऑफ डिटेल. इससे ये भी दिख रहा है कि नॉर्थ अमेरिका में देर आर नो लॉन्गर एनी नेचुरली अकरिंग हॉर्सेस. Right, they got extinct here in itself in Pleistocene time, but some of them migrated to Africa and Eurasia, and we have the modern horse naturally here. So, right, just using these three words and putting this dot, now I have given a lot of information which might not appear obvious to you if you are new to this topic. Right, this Euhippus sometime is also known as Hyracotherium. Right, but I found this more fancy. More easy to remember, Euhippus, right? So I think we have a decent amount of right. This is the last slide, and then we will stop, right? So what are the environmental causes leading to this evolution? Is since forest say change in environment was to grassland in Cenozoic time, so there was a need for greater speed. All right, so for greater speed, they also need more body size, more powerful legs to escape from predators. So this was one of the reading. All right, another thing is cooling of the climate in the Cenozoic, where it induced the replacement of forest to grassland. All right, then this elongated muzzle to reach to the grass easier. All right, grasses became high in silica, so teeth became more crowned. No, it is an adaptive feature. So this is it. So this we discussed already, this diagram, and again the same diagram in some another form. Right, so like that is it. We will end the session here. Tomorrow we will take we will spend 15-20 minutes, and we will take up each and every, like we did for human, we will dwell on all specific ancestor of horse, Euhippus, right? Then we will talk about this second one is Mesohippus, then the third one is Myohippus, Parahippus, right? Merychippus, then what we have Equus, right? We will discuss this in 15-20 minutes, and then this is the final output, right? Everything what we will read. So this is, again, if this question came in exam, draw this diagram in 10 marker, in 20 marker or 25 marker, in the second and the third page write something on Euhippus, two lines on Orohippus, Mesohippus, Myohippus, Merychippus, Pliohippus, all right, and you are good to have a 90% score in this question. So this is what we will do tomorrow. Right, so we can end the class. And if you want to remember the mnemonic for these terms, I also shared this, but unfortunately it is only in Hindi. So like people who are not comfortable in Hindi, use your innovation and use it. So this is, you read it yourself. So I think we will end the class here tomorrow, or whenever the class is there, maybe class will be tomorrow or maybe day after tomorrow, we will complete this Equus, and we will also complete the elephant, evolution of elephant.
Hello.